Published 0352 EDT, the 15th of August 2017. Updated 0406 EDT, the 15th of August 2017. Three-course lunch is served by a personal waiter in a blossom-filled almond grove, candlelit dinners beneath the stars in the Sahara Desert, and a refreshing glass of local wine on a roof terrace overlooking the city of Marrakech. I don't want to gloat, but this is exactly the kind of Hollywood movie-style indulgence I enjoyed on a recent holiday to Morocco. I always knew the North African country was a popular honeymoon destination, but I hadn't bargained for quite how magical and how romantic it would be. Dar Alam translates from Arabic to House of Dreams, and there has never been a truer name. The five-star, all-inclusive establishment prides itself on the theatrical, from the atmospheric entrance procession through dark corridors dimly lit by candles to the ever-changing scenery around the property. Dar Alam translates from Arabic to House of Dreams, and my goodness, there has never been a truer name. The five-star, all-inclusive establishment prides itself on the theatrical, from the atmospheric entrance procession through dark corridors dimly lit by candles to the ever-changing scenery around the property. What might be a room furnished with a plain wooden table one day could feature three covered with tablecloths the next, with golden plates and huge, elaborate candlesticks worthy of a cathedral warmly lighting the space. Rather than offering a set restaurant with a menu, guests here will never dine in the same place twice and no meal is the same. Everything is a very wonderful surprise. The first night, following a dip in the large, delightful pool, my boyfriend and I were led by a waiter to a small building that could every inch have been the priest's apothecary in Romeo and Juliet. It was filled with pots and wicker baskets of fresh herbs. The heady scents of rosemary, lemon balm and mint filled the candlelit room while ground spices were piled high in clay pots. A wood-burning oven stood in the corner and an old birdcage hung from the ceiling. If only it'd been in costume, it could have been a scene from a historical drama. This was definitely my kind of hotel. Rather than offering a set restaurant with a menu, guests here will never dine in the same place twice and no meal is the same. Everything is a very wonderful surprise. What might be a room furnished with one plain wooden table one day could feature three the next, with huge candlesticks worthy of a cathedral warmly lighting the altered space and golden plates decorating the sideboard. A huge pool left is the perfect place to cool off after a dusty day exploring the nearby oasis. There's also a vast garden to relax in right when ready for any of their three meals. Guests simply show themselves in the main living area and they are instantly whisked away to their dedicated spot for their feast. The room's decor fits in with the desert theme, with neutral, earthy shades coloring the walls and furnishings. The bathrooms are vast and luxurious. Top tip: ask a member of staff to light the fire and spend the evening relaxing in a hot bubble bath. Breakfast is an alfresco affair in good weather and includes fresh orange juice and toasted bread with jams and pastries left, and at night the hotel is transformed, with guests' evening meals taking place at various romantic spots all over the property, including on the roof. Right Mile Online Travels: Harriet Mallinson lunched in an almond grove by pure fortune, visiting at a time when the almond trees were in full bloom. We were served a delicious pumpkin soup with sourdough bread, followed by roasted chicken and lentils, all infused with the spices and herbs that surrounded us to fit with the night's theme. The ambiance was just perfect, although it was somewhat comical to see our waiter craning his head around the corner, meerkat-like, to check when we needed our wine refilling or the next course served. The following day, as agreed with our personal guide the day before, we took bicycles out into the surrounding oasis and spent the morning pedaling round among the palms in the hot sun, fulfilling all my romantic comedy montage requirements. We lunched in an almond grove. By pure fortune, we were visiting at a time when the almond trees were in full bloom and their delightful small pink and white flowers were glorious under the bright blue sky, not to mention positively bridal when the petals fell confettilike in the breeze. The ruins of a deserted town added to the already stunningly romantic backdrop. I have never felt more like I was starring in a Taylor Swift music video in all my life. Our very own dining table was set up in a clearing where we were brought a divine three-course lunch by our waiter. Oh Lord, my waistline. The hotel really did think of everything, providing straw hats as well as a puerto around the corner. But the highlight of our stay had to be the night we spent in Dar Alam's luxury desert camp. After a whopping 4-hour drive, I found myself more in the middle of nowhere than I've ever been in my whole life. A highlight of a stay at Dar Alam has to be a trip to the hotel's mind-blowing desert camp, several hours' drive away. Nevertheless, being stuck in the Sahara does not stop the hotel providing an astounding level of service. The canvas tent is large and sumptuous and features a large double bed, which later is even furnished with hot water bottles. There is even a bathroom area with a toilet, a sink and water plus towels, as well as a living space, while lanterns are lit and dotted around the area to take the romance levels up a notch. An outdoor seating area allows guests to enjoy the scenery from the shade, perhaps with a cooling cocktail in hand. In this camp, it's easy to feel utterly in the middle of nowhere and totally alone, making watching the sunrise and set a wonderfully peaceful experience. Nevertheless, being stuck in the Sahara did not stop the hotel providing an astounding level of service. Our canvas tent was large and sumptuous, and, unlike the ghastly Twoman leaking tent I once used at a music festival, it featured a large double bed which later was even furnished with hot water bottles, a bathroom area with a toilet, a sink and water plus towels, as well as a living space. We watched the sunset on the top of a dune, lolling on cushions, a gin and tonic in our hands, amazed how spoilt we were, but the best was yet to come. After darkness fell, waiters brought out lanterns, dotting them along the sand to lead the way to dinner over the adjacent dune, and the sight I saw when I crested the top was truly spellbinding. Like something out of a fairy tale, tens of flickering lanterns filled the valley, lighting up the ochre sand. In the middle of it all was a table set for a formal dinner for two next to a roaring fire pit, while above us teemed endless stars. Had I died and gone to heaven? The captivating and endlessly romantic setting has continued, to this day, to take my breath away. Sadly, our time with Dar Alam had to come to an end, and the next day we made our way back across the Atlas Mountains to Marrakech. Here we stayed at La Sultana Marrakech, just moments from the royal palaces, museums and souks of the city. This too was overwhelming. Intricate wooden carvings, decorative archways, alcoves with plump silky cushions. Just wandering around the hotel was a voyage of discovery. You never knew what you were going to stumble upon next. La Sultana Marrakech is just moments from the royal palaces, museums and souks of the city. La Sultana boasts intricate wooden carvings, decorative archways, alcoves with plump silky cushions. Just wandering around the hotel is a voyage of discovery. Each sumptuous room is themed, with some dedicated to elephants, other to tigers. Beautiful bathrooms have wonderful gold scalloped sinks, and above the bath in an alcove are metal stars left. There are many living areas around the property. One features leather chairs with horned backs and armrests. Right, the palatial spa is decorated with ornate traditional lanterns, while its perfumed oils often waft up to the upstairs courtyard. The terrace on the top of the building was the perfect place for a crisp glass of wine at the end of the day. Exploring the city, the call to prayer from the nearby mosque filling the air, and the Atlas Mountains rising majestically in the distance. Breakfast was eaten by a pool in the main courtyard, while the terrace on the top of the building was the perfect place for a crisp glass of wine at the end of the day. Exploring the city, the call to prayer from the nearby mosque filling the evening air. Our suite was absolutely gorgeous. The room focused around the enormous bed, above which hung a huge picture of two tigers. If you couldn't let your animal side out here, where could you? The beautiful bathroom had wonderful gold scalloped sinks. Above the bath in an alcove were metal stars, and a rose worthy of the Beauty and the Beast stood on the side. Even the ceiling above the toilet had amazing wooden carvings. The attention to detail never failed to amaze me. So in short, yes, my time in Morocco infuriated all my friends back at home following me on Instagram. I say I don't want to gloat, but who am I kidding? Book a stay at Dar Alam with small luxury hotels of the world from £743 per night on an all-inclusive basis. The Nomad Camp overnight costs from £1,410 to sharing, which includes a transfer to the desert, one night in an exclusive tent for two guests, as well as all meals and beverages. www.slh.com. Dar Alam 0800-048-2314. Book a stay at La Sultana Marrakech with small luxury hotels of the world from £272 per night to sharing on a room-only basis. www.slh.com. La Sultana 0800-048-2314.